Have you ever wanted to be in your own one-man show? Well, today we're going to learn just how with actress and playwright Tracey Erin Smith. Welcome to the show.
Thanks, Glenn.
So you now do what's called solo theater. Mm-hmm. Now tell us about what that is and how it got started.
Great question. Solo theater is helping people, actors, non-actors, doctors, lawyers, housewives, streetwalkers, anything.
Streetwalker.
Anything. Everyone has a story, especially them. Take raw material from their lives and transform it into a solo performance.
Now, yeah, because a lot of people would probably think that their life isn't that interesting and worth the performance. So how do you get there with people?
Well, really, if you've lived even more than 2 years, you have stories. So a lot of people, that's sort of part of the resistance. They'll say, you know, I don't have any stories. And then after the first class, I had a first class last night,
Okay. People
are not sure which one to pick. Because there's
really,
so many.
So now your classes are how big? Like, because it is a class.
You do class.
And you're doing courses.
I take about 10 people.
Okay.
Because I really need to focus on everyone's story and help them develop it.
Okay, so if I was to come there, I mean, I'm pretty riveting though.
You are beyond riveting.
what process would you take people through?
Well, first of all, I've got a lot of hints about you already just from the intro and things like that.
Okay.
So I would probably get you to write a story about playing the trombone when you were 10 and being a child prodigy. You could also write about your idea to be Gaddafi's stylist. I think those would weave together nicely. And last night we did an exercise where people write about their name. How did their name come to be? What nicknames have they had?
And Bacon, because I was a fat kid.
Well, there you go. Exactly. Mm-hmm. So you could do a few minutes on being called Bacon and what that was like then. And
I would never want to talk about that again. That would be devastating.
Well, yeah.
So it's a combination writing and performance course.
Yes, exactly. The first part is going fishing for the story.
Okay.
So we do that through writing exercises, improvisation exercises. I also used to teach at Second City. So I help people sort of what I call write on their feet.
Okay.
And that's getting up and trying different things.
Yeah, because it's hard for people. I've taken improv classes, and I don't know if anybody out there has taken improv classes. At first, it's very awkward because it's like you're a tree, you're a chicken, you're a whatever. It's pretty funny.
Yeah.
And then it teaches you sort of how to loosen up, really.
It teaches you how to loosen up. It teaches you spontaneous thinking, how to be in the moment. And I don't do anything too wacky like that. We really are focused on people's stories.
Okay, so then you start with the writing where everyone writes things down.
Mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
then from there, what happens next?
Well, then stories start to emerge. So either something from childhood or I've had a woman did a wonderful piece who was from Britain who came to live in Canada. Mm-hmm. But she sort of came to Canada on a 6-month dare and then decided to move here.
Okay.
So it was her story. Another woman did a piece about the aging process. So she called her piece Camouflage. She came on stage with no makeup and one of those old makeup mirrors, like from the 80s with all the different settings.
Yep, yep.
And she applied her makeup while she told her life story.
Incredible. So these individuals have actually taken it to the next level, right?
Well, actually, at the end of the course, they present a 10-minute polished piece.
Okay.
And some of them have gone on to create one-hour shows, and that woman took her show to New York. Others have performed it across Canada.
That's incredible, incredible. What I like about it is it's also a course that will teach you how to tell a story, because a lot of people can't tell stories.
Exactly, and nothing hooks people more than a story, whether it's for business or at a cocktail party or speed dating. A story, all of a sudden our ears prick up and we're interested.
So is that what the takeaway is from your workshop, is that people can actually learn how to start, middle, and end a story? And like, so what is the benefit? What are some of the other stories? Because you were talking about in the makeup room about a cancer survivor.
Yes, she was taking one of my improv classes actually at Ryerson, and all of a sudden she just blurted out, you know, she said, "I only lose weight when I have cancer." And
wow.
I said, "Oh my goodness, that's your title." So
wow.
She came and took the class, and she talked about how she's had cancer. I believe it's come back 3 times, and she's healthy as a horse right now.
Oh, fantastic.
But she said the first signifier is, I start to go down in weight. I mean, and she gets excited, and then she realizes, no.
Oh, it's not for the good reasons. And so what's the ripple effect of what you're doing? Because, like, what's the after effects?
The after effects are really quite amazing. Some people that take the course have never done public speaking, let alone sort of a theater piece on stage. And then at the end, after the performance night, I have what we call an opening and closing night party, because it's just a one-off, it's just a one-time. And people, it seems to me, that their sense of self and what they can do is expanded, because they're like, oh my gosh, if I can do that, what else can I do? And people have gone on to skydive, take stand-up comedy classes, get married. So that's the scariest one, get married.
I would see it as quite empowering, right?
Yeah.
So, because you would get so inspired. If I could do this, I could do anything.
Exactly. And another way that I refer to it is it's like coming out of the closet as a human being. So we see everyone has trials. Everyone sometimes thinks they suck. Everyone lies on the couch for a day or two. Mm-hmm. And when you hear, oh my gosh, other people do that too, it's like your shoulders relax and you think, okay, I'm okay.
Now, does the class become friends really quickly? I would see it as perhaps
amazing bonding. Because emotions come up. It's not therapy, but it can be very therapeutic. Just to speak your truth and be heard.
And with a group of strangers, potentially, correct?
That's what's amazing. If I could take a snapshot of this group of 10 strangers and then how close they are at the end.
So at the beginning, they're strangers, and at the end, they're like having drinks together and dinners together.
Yeah.
Amazing. So you also are a professor at Ryerson, or you teach at Ryerson.
Yeah.
So is that where the classes are? So where are the classes
taking place? I teach at Ryerson. I often teach out of Second City. And tomorrow night I have a class starting at Bloor and Spadina at the Miles Nadell JCC, and I have two spots left in that
one. Oh, fantastic.
So for anyone out there that's feeling a little tingle and sort of thinking, oh my gosh, maybe I could do that.
So where would somebody go for the information?
It's my website, www.soulo.ca, solo. So it's like singular, like solo theater, but it's like putting your soul on stage.
Well, I read some of the stories after, some of the people that wrote about it, and they're all like, you. Not only did you inspire them outwardly, but you also inspired them inwardly. So how could you go wrong? You're going to learn how to tell a story, you're going to meet some new friends, and your soul is going to be touched. I think it's pretty impressive.
Thank you so much, Glenn.
Thank you for coming.